I'm standing right now with two of the senior most journalists from the field of entertainment industry in Mumbai. There's Jyoti Venkatesh and Pannu sir. We will be discussing about Sarkaar 3, which has not really made any big noise at the box office, and neither has it received any great response from film critics either. Let's try and talk to Jyoti sir and Pannu sir and try and understand what was their reaction about Sarkaar 3 once they watched it. Jyoti sir, let me begin with you. What did you think about Sarkaar 3? Did you like it?
I won't say I didn't like it or I hated it, but when I saw Sarkaar 3, I thought what difference is there from Sarkaar 1, Sarkaar 2, Sarkaar 3. They are beating around the same bush and nothing new content-wise. And another problem, I found that he has not spent at all, just inside one indoor set and little bit of outdoor. And how can you expect Ramu to continue this kind of a treatment in 2017?
So the production value as well as the plot didn't really make any impact on you?
Yeah, it was more predictable, and you can easily realize what the next scene is going to be.
Okay. Pannu sir, what about you?
Yeah, you see, when you hear the name Sarkaar, you immediately say okay, it must be on the Thackeray family or, you know, but it's not so in Sarkaar 3. In Sarkaar 2, the Enron controversy was there, Ramu encashed on it.
Correct.
But here, there is nothing like that. And when you see, then you keep on guessing that this character will come from here, this character will come from here, this character will come from here, this character will come from here. But it's not like that. Only plus point is, Ramu shot 80% of this film in one set. Mm. And Jackie Shroff's shot there in Dubai. And there are hardly any big sets or big expenses on this.
Okay.
So it means the film is it hasn't crossed any budgets or anything. And Ramu technically he shot very well on this one set, and the budget is the main constraint to make the film successful.
Okay.
Because the film is shot with a limited budget.
Okay.
And Sarkaar, the name Sarkaar has a brand value, so it will help because the film has no over budget.
But Jyoti sir, were you expecting something of this sort, a substandard product from Ramu, or were you deeply disappointed?
No, I was expecting a superior product. The way the hype had been done for Sarkaar 3, I said it's going to surpass the earlier Sarkaar.
Okay.
But I was in for disappointment when I said nothing is stirring me or making me feel, oh, what is happening?
Okay.
And unfortunately, you didn't ask me the question, but I will tell you.
Okay.
Yami Gautam's career has been ruined by doing this kind of a negative role, where she has nothing to do. There's no romantic portion. And even the negativity is not properly etched.
Okay.
And also, but one person I liked was Amit Sar.
Amit Sar.
Even though he is a comparatively new entrant in the game, but at least he could get a better chance to express himself.
Okay.
And another person I liked in the film was Ronit Roy.
Okay.
The controlled
person. Okay.
As an actor.
Okay. What about you, sir? Did you like Yami Gautam or dislike Yami Gautam?
You see, Yami Gautam, you know, post-Kabil, I was expecting something good from her. And here, she is here to take a revenge. And you know, and she shoots and that doesn't gel with the what Yami will.
Okay. Maza nahi aaya.
Maza nahi aaya. Aur Yami ke kirdaar ke andar, acha ya to hota hai ki ek andar se aag hoti hai na. To wo jo ek hota hai, yahan pe Yami apna, you know, double crossing everyone.
Okay.
And there has to be some specifications.
Okay.
Second thing, in the climax, they have shown Sarkaar and his Amit Sar sitting team.
Correct.
So, ye samajh gaya Sarkaar 4 aane wali hai.
Sir, just a few quick questions more. What about Amitabh Bachchan? Were you happy with his performance?
Amitabh is such a person. He has always been delivering consistently good performance. So, I can't pick calls, but somehow he became very stereotyped as Sarkaar.
Okay, and that you didn't enjoy. Yes, Pannu sir?
Yeah. Amitabh ko Yash Chopra ne Diwar mein apna Kala Patthar, Trishul aur film mein direct kiya. Unhone memorable film diya.
अमिताभ को रामू ने सरकार 1 2 3 रण और अपना राम गोपाल वर्मा की आग और अपना निशब्द में डायरेक्ट किया, बट राम गोपाल वर्मा 6 फिल्में डायरेक्ट, 6 से भी ज़्यादा हो गई हो सकता है, बट 6 फिल्में वो यादगार फिल्म नहीं दे पाए जो यश चोपड़ा दे पाए। तो यहाँ पे राम की कमजोरी सामने आती
है, फेलियर है ऐसे डायरेक्टर,
ऐसे डायरेक्टर फेलियर है क्योंकि आपके पास अमिताभ बच्चन है तो सर आप यश चोपड़ा की तरह यादगार फिल्में दइए,
करेक्ट,
वरना अपना अमिताभ बच्चन को वेस्ट मत कीजिए।
ओके, दैट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट। सो डू यू थिंक रामू इज लूजिंग हिज चार्म एज अ डायरेक्टर एंड मे बी प्रॉब्ली यू शुड टेक अ स्टेप बैक एंड थिंक वेयर इज गोइंग एज फॉर हिज प्रोफेशनल करियर गोइंग?
या ही इज लूजिंग हिज चार्म, बट द प्रॉब्लम इज रामू इज इन द अंडर द इंप्रेशन दैट you make a film in Hindi, small budget, and dub it in Tamil, Telugu, and then you can recover the cost, because now the problem that Ramu is having, or rather I feel that Ramu is having, is that he feels I can recover, the idea is to recover the cost,
okay,
instead of making film like Rangila or Satya. I remember Satya when he made, he showed the film 15 days in advance to me.
Okay, oh he did.
And I, later on, I got the opportunity to censor the film.
Censor the film, okay.
I censored it also. And after I censored the film, Ramu rang me up and he said, sir, I have a request with you, from you. I was worried. I thought he will say, there is some certificate problem, help me.
Okay.
But he said, nahi, I am very happy that you censored the film at VC, examination committee level.
Okay.
So, I'll be very happy if you can join me for lunch or dinner.
Wow.
I went and had a lunch with him, and then in International Film Festival Satya was shown, there was a brochure where director had to be interviewed. He, without asking my permission, he gave the interview which I did in afternoon, he used it in festival bulletin.
Finally sir, do you think Amitabh should perhaps stop working with Ramu, or Ramu should perhaps stop making films like Sarkar?
No,
do you see it?
No, one thing is, ek director of kaun si film mein किसी कलाकार को कितना निचोड़ लेगा वो कोई कह नहीं सकता। ठीक है, रामू ने अमिताभ बच्चन साहब के साथ अपना कई फिल्में की हैं, बट ये बात है रामू में, अगर वो सत्य में मनोज बाजपेयी को इतना उभार के लाया, कहीं ना कहीं बच्चन साहब के साथ इतना फिल्म किया, ये फिल्म है जो है रामू हैज ऑल द पोटेंशियल टू टेक
द बेस्ट आउट ऑफ
दैट
वी हैवंट सीन टिल डू यू थिंक सरकार 4 बनाना चाहिए उनको?
जरूर बनाना चाहिए, और उसमें बच्चन साहब को जो है एक नए रंग में और एक नए रूप में, एक नए किरदार में पेश करना चाहिए, और रामू को सोचना चाहिए व्हाट नेक्स्ट, क्योंकि 1 2 3 में तो हम देख चुके हैं, 4 में रामू को इसे चैलेंज लेते हुए, एज रामू लव द चैलेंज, इसे चैलेंज लेते हुए उनको एक अलग ही जो है
closing comments from you, do you think, are you waiting for Sarkar 4 as well after the debacle of Sarkar 3, or would you have a different opinion?
Yeah, in spite of the debacle of Sarkar 3, I am confident that Ramu will make Sarkar 4 and show the relationship between the grandfather and the grandson and the dramatic conflict with this result, and then showing further how he is resolving this.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Sir, and this is Sonu signing off from Bollywood Wala. Keep tuned to my channel for more discussions and debates from the world of Bollywood.
Sonu Prox.